What's up, YouTube? This is James coming back at you with another informative video. I hope you guys are doing well up on this beautiful midweek Wednesday. Doing well myself. I come across this particular situation right here with these two Brownsville teachers. To the left of you, you have Sarah Seymour, 27 years old. And to the right of you, 63-year-old Deborah Canopy. I guess that's her name, Canopy, something like that. You understand? But they are alleged to have made a 7-year-old special needs child at the school in a lunchroom eat his own vomit. Okay? Yeah, you heard me right. They are alleged to have lost their license because they made a 7-year-old special needs student eat his own vomit. Okay? And as you can see, the young hag and the old hag here that is alleged to have done this, and I believe they did, you know, sitting here with this basically careless look on their face like, so what, you know. What I want to do is for us to sit back and check out this particular video, and then we'll get into the commentary.
Tonight, we now know the reason that 5 elementary school staffers are in trouble in Brownsburg.
Well, we do have to warn you, you might find the description of these allegations disturbing. Our Lauren Kostick actually just spoke with police and shares what they saw on that video.
These allegations are just disturbing. 5 staff members now facing criminal charges after not only allegedly forcing the student to eat his own vomit, but also clean it up.
You know, I think anybody who watches the video, you know, it's going to be a pendulum of emotions.
That video taking place at Brown Elementary School during lunchtime. Police say it shows a 7-year-old boy eating his food. His teacher, Sarah Seymour, was on his left, and Deborah Knipe, an instructional aide, was on his right, along with 3 other staff members nearby.
And at some point, he goes to stand up, and he looks as if he's gagging. It appears that he's been instructed to sit back down, at which point, within a few seconds to a few minutes, he actually does projectile vomit onto a tray and onto the lunch table in front of him. Within a few seconds of that, we see Ms. Knipe, who's on his right, provide him a spoon, at which point he's compelled to eat several bites of his vomit.
Police say this incident happened back in February and that the school didn't know about it until 2 weeks ago. The boy involved is part of the school's life skills program and has a cognitive disability that affects his memory.
He is verbal, but again, with the memory being affected, he wasn't able to tell us that this happened back in February.
In a statement, the school corporation said this horrendous action is not in line with the character of staff and teachers at Brownsburg schools. The shocking actions of a few does not define the care and concern that Brownsburg teachers and staff show every day. The 5 staff members are facing charges, including neglect of a dependent and failure to report.
At the end of the day, they failed. They failed our children, they failed that child, and they failed all of us.
And the school corporation tells me they are moving forward with terminating 2 of those staff members. The others remain on administrative leave. In Brownsburg, Lauren Kostick, 13 News.
Man, I'm telling you, there's just no compassion anywhere in this world these days for the most part, and especially in these schools. When you send your child out your house to go to these schools, you are sending them around a lot of strangers that has no compassion whatsoever and shouldn't even be teaching in the educational system. You understand? As for these two right here, there should be criminal charges put on both of them, you see, for what they are alleged to have done. Okay, I just say alleged because, well, that's what the news is saying. They said they're on camera making them do it, you know. Now, neither one of them would want to eat their own vomit. You understand what I'm saying? They'll say, you know, that's inhumane, you know, to treat someone like that. They would recognize that that's wrong. You don't do that to me. You understand? But they want to make a defenseless, okay, special needs child do it. What that tell you about these low lights right here? You understand? Criminal charges should be put on their asses, and they need to be put in some facility, you know, jail, prison, you know, for duration of time, a good duration, you understand, around people with the same attitude that they got, and they have no power to fight off, if you understand what I'm saying. So then they can understand how that little 7-year-old boy felt when they did that to him. This is what should happen to these two hags right here. Lowlifes, scums of society. You know, the thing is this. If you're not hearing about them molesting children in these schools, you're hearing about them abusing them. And this was abuse right here. Plain and simple. This was abuse right here. That's filthy what you made this little boy did. See? So yeah, as far as I'm concerned, they shouldn't only, you know, lose their license. They should be jailed. Criminal charges put on them, jailed, and treated the very same way or worse of what you did to that 7-year-old boy. Okay? And that's just what it is. That's all I got on this one, people. I want you guys to tell me in the comment section what you think about this particular situation. I'm interested in hearing your views on it. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. People, please remember to live your life as though we're being watched, simply because we are. This is James, and I'm out. Peace.